Hello everyone, welcome to another video that doesn't sound like I was raised on TikTok. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get all of the legendary armaments, the legendary incantations and sorceries, the legendary talismans, and the legendary ashen remains in Elden Ring. A couple of things to take note of before you start this guide. First of all, you're going to want to follow the Ranni's questline to get some of these collectibles. If you don't know how to do that, I suggest looking it up. Because you're going to have to follow along with that to get some of these. You don't have to do it right now, but there will come a point where you're going to have to follow along with that quest line to get some of these collectibles. Also, you'll want to go ahead and make sure you haven't turned the city into ash. The capital city needs to be intact. When you beat the boss, the Black Blade, in the crumbling Farum Azula towards the end of the game, the city gets turned to ash, and you want to make sure that that hasn't happened. Before you follow this guide, you will have to get a collectible there at the very end of this guide, but it is the very last one, and you'll just want to make sure that you don't miss out on the collectible that's in the capital before it turns to ash. I also wanted to add that my audio clips got messed up for these recordings, so I've just added the Elden Ring theme music in the background for it. Let's get started. Okay, so we're starting out in Limgrave. At the Church of Pilgrimage, we're heading south-southeast sort of direction. This one's for Lutel the Headless, which is the first of six ashes. 30 items we gotta get in total. You'll know you're in the right place for this one because you'll see jellyfish around the entrance of the tomb we'll go into. I've tried to keep these in order as best I could, going through the areas that you'll sort of naturally progress through. I've probably mentioned this in the intro, but you'll probably want to start New Game Plus to do this if you've reached the point where you have the capital of Ash instead of the capital city. Then you're going to lock yourself out of a couple of the pickups here, so that's why I've tried to keep it in order. Probably mentioned this in the intro. Right here I'm just going to run through the catacombs here. I've killed all the enemies. There's a bunch of skeletons in this area. But just to show you the route through, I'll do this for a few of the more complicated areas. It's crazy how many areas there are in this game. Watch out for the fire here, you need to duck into the right. Like I mentioned, the ending you're going to have to get for this is, I think it's called the Moon and Stars ending or something. You need to smack this platform down and then jump on it to get up here to get to the switch to open the boss area. You need to follow Ranni's questline to get a good few of these collectibles. Lots of skeletons in this room. Be wary of them when you come up here. So if you don't know how to do Ranni's questline, you might want to give that a quick search because it's very long. I could include it in this video, but it would probably make the video like another hour longer at least. Because there's a lot of stuff you've got to do, but if you don't know how to start it, you start it in the Carrier Manor, but I'd advise looking it up. One skeleton seemed to get away from me there, just get rid of him quickly, and the boss room is just here. So you're going to have to beat this boss to get the Ashen Remains. Some of these take longer than others. I'll try to have chapters set up in the description with the video so you can skip between them if you want. Kill the Cemetery Shade to get Lutel the Headless. That's the first one. Sorted. Alright, next up, we're still in Limgrave. Going to the War Master's Shack, which is right there. This one's for the Devourer's Scepter. There's Stormhill Shack, it's just to the right of that. Stormhill Shack is one you'll get on the way to Margit. So you'll meet this merchant here. You need to kill him to get his armor and his weapon. Get rid of him. And you'll also get his belt bearings. He can buy the stuff he has from the Twin Maiden Husks at the round table. So right there, the legendary item is the Devourer's Scepter. That's the first armament. Still in Limgrave, we are beside the Rampart Gaol. Or at least that's the site of grace closest to this area. I think I took the map view then from after the fight I had with this boss. But this is to the very, very southern point of Limgrave. Drop down here to where the jellyfish are and go to the boss area. And, beat this boss. Get yourself the Grafted Blade Greatsword. I think this is one of the few legendary items that I actually found naturally. So much stuff in this game just requires you to look it up. But yeah, beat him and get the Grafted Blade Greatsword. That's the second armament. Okay, moving on to Liania then. We're at the Liania Lake Shore. This is the first legendary incantation or sorcery called Flame of the Fell God. You'll need to come in a northern direction over here and sort of head northwest when you can, and then you'll find this jump area. I think Spirit Jumping it's called or something like that. And come to the Evergowl area. Male Factors Evergowl. Enter this, beat the boss, and you'll be rewarded with Flame of the Fell God for beating him. This guy isn't too tough if you're a decent level. Early on in the game, you might find him a little more tricky. But he's definitely beatable. So that's our fourth legendary item, Flame of the Fell God. Not too much of a complicated one. Next up, still in Liania, we're starting from the Debate Parlor. This is where you fight, is it Radagon's wolf or something like that? The big red wolf boss. And this is our first talisman, Radagon Icon. When you come out of the door here, you'll want to turn around and jump over this railing, climb up this ladder. This one's quite easy to get. You don't really have to fight anything to get it, although you will have to beat the boss to get to this area. But again, it's kind of like a natural progression type thing. Alright, so jump through here and come up these stairs and open up the chest that's on your left to get the talisman. So, still in Liania for this one. This is armament number 3. We're starting at the main Carrier Manor Gate. This is for the Sword of Night and Flame. You may already have this one. This one was really popular with videos and stuff, so it's quite a common one for people to get. I think people like this weapon so much just because it's easy to come and get early on. You don't have to fight anything to get it. You can just run straight here and get it if you want to. I'm not sure, but I think they may have nerfed it. I know the Ice Rind Hatchet has been nerfed, or at least Hoarfrost Stomp has that's on it. It's still pretty powerful. It's still a powerful weapon, but there's definitely better weapons now. I just kind of held on to it. It's still good to get some range on some enemies, and I just had it upgraded, so I just kept using it. This was New Game Plus, though, and I'm pretty sure that means enemies are tougher, like each time you go through to like journey number 2 or 3, the enemies get tougher, although you do get more runes, which is nice. So if you're doing rune farming, you can smash it if you're doing New Game Plus or Journey number 2. So all the way around here then, avoiding all of those enemies, come down this ladder, and the chest is just at the bottom of this ladder. Right here. There's your sword. Alright, so quickly show that on the map. Next up, we're at the Altus Plateau. Starting at the Altus Highway Junction, we need to go down to the Golden Lineage Evergoal. I'm pretty sure I'd already beaten this boss, so I can't show you me getting this talisman, but I can just show you where it is. Basically, you need to go there and fight, I think it's a version of Godric, and you'll get the Godfrey icon, which is our second talisman, number 7 on this list. I could have split this video into like 4 different videos for each thing, but I felt like it would just be easier in the long run to have everything in one video, because if you go in for one of these achievements, you're probably going to want all 4 of them, or trophies, if you're on PlayStation. I'm not platform biased. I really don't care what you play on. I hate all platforms equally, don't worry, man. Although, from what I've heard, interestingly enough, this game's easier to play on controller. I don't know how true that is, but some people seem to think it is. I feel like there's probably benefits to both. You're also going to need a stone sword key to access this Evergal. And let me scroll through all of these different tabs to show you the icon. There we are. And it's that one. Enhances charge spells and skills. One of the few things I have two of. Alright, so still at the Altus Plateau. We are starting at the Rampart side path. Right here. You'll need to run in the direction of the Erd Tree if you haven't been to this area before, and then around the path. Alright. So, watch out for the lightning in this area. This is for the Ancient Dragon Knight Kristoff Ashes, which is our second set of legendary Ashen Remains. Some of these take a lot longer to get than others. A lot of them don't really require you to do, like, quest lines. But there are a few that require you to do, specifically Vranny's quest line. If you've been to Nokron and Noxtella, those areas are essential for getting all of these collectibles. And if you're unsure how to get there, your best bet is to just go and Google it and have a look. Although I'm guessing if you've beaten Star Scourge Radahn, whatever his name is, you'll probably have gained access to those areas. Alright, so again, I'll show you the route through this place. I'm unsure if I'd beaten everything in here or not, I probably did. Just to make it clear, follow along with me. I know I'm a little bit late to the party with this video, by the way, but I've recently been busy and also sick. I caught a certain virus recently, which wasn't a lot of fun. But I am on the mend. For anyone who might have been worried. Alright, let's go down here. So the deal is with these guys, you have to get them onto the lit platforms there so they lose the shadow sort of stuff that's on them, and then you can do damage to them after you do that. You're going to come through here and fall through the floor. Eventually, you'll come to this area and then you have to pull this switch to unlock the boss area. These guys don't have the sort of black shadow stuff on them, so you can just kill them if you want to, although these guys are really slow, so you can just sort of run past them. Not really too much of a worry. These guys can be annoying with their spells. Actually managed to get smacked there by the blade. They do a ton of damage, so be careful. And then this guy wanted to get a free meal, I guess. Plenty of flasks though, so I'm not worried. Alright. So when you're down here, this is where the boss fight is, more or less, through this door at the bottom. Beat the boss to get Dragon Knight Kristoff. I haven't used a lot of these ashes, so I don't know which ones are the best. I've heard about a couple of them. I use Mimic Teal myself. But I know there's another one that's supposed to be really good that you get from one of the later areas in Rani's questline. But there it is. It's our second legendary Ashen Remains. Still at the Altus Plateau then. We're at the Shaded Castle this time. It's a pretty straightforward area to get through this. Basically, you have to beat the boss at the end of this area. Doesn't take that long to get through. It's not like the catacombs that are difficult to get through. It's also a pretty visible area on the map as well, just to the left of the Altus Plateau. But yeah, beat this guy and you'll get Marius Executioner's Sword, which is our fourth armament. You'll also get the Briar Great Shield. That isn't an item required for this list, but you get it anyway. Alright, so still in the Altus Plateau. We're starting at the Erd Tree Gazing Hill, but we're trying to get to the Primeval Sorcerer Azura. If you've been
to him already, and you've got that sight of grace where I just sort of hovered over there. Just go straight to there and speak to the guy. If you haven't, this is how you get there. It's actually kind of a tricky one to get to, so I wouldn't blame you if you just followed along with me from the tree-gazing hill. We're going to come up here and through this area. We do pass a few sites of grace if you want to grab them along the way, but I feel like that one right there is an easy one to start from. It's an easy one to find. So yeah, I wouldn't blame you if you started from there. So I think there's a site of grace here just on the right. Yeah, there we go. Mount Gelmir. I don't think this takes you up towards Volcano Manor. There's another way to get up to that area. I'm sure many of you have found it by now, but yeah, I don't think this actually does take you up there, although it's very close to that area. Also a golden seed here along the way if you want to grab that. Okay. So keep following the path around to the left here. I know it's a bit of a long run, but I thought it'd be better to just show you guys everything we need to do. After this one, we need to go back to Limgrave for another one, because once you've got this sorcery, which is Comet Azure, there's a place you go to in Limgrave and show that sorcery to someone else, and they give you a lead on another area where you can get a legendary sorcery. So we'll do that one next. I purposely left this one to the end of the Altus Plateau, just so you were done here before you had to go back there. And once you've been there, to get that item, we have to go to Caelid. So I've set it up so that we do Caelid directly after getting back to Limgrave. Kind of made sense just to do it that way. Okay, so when you do get into the area we're about to reach, there's a boss there. It's not a particularly tough boss. You might want to beat it, but that's up to you. It isn't this magma worm. You can just run past this guy. Don't worry too much about him. So we're going in between the rocks right here. Past all these graves, and then over here to the left, and then keep going forward. In this next area is where the little boss is I was talking about. I know this is quite a run, but getting to this area is actually a bit weird. It's kind of a difficult area to reach if you haven't been there before, and I know routes can be a bit confusing on this game, so I just wanted to do my best to include the way there for most of these. If it's relatively simple, then I won't include the route, just because I feel like some of them are very straightforward to get to, others aren't. Also, you know, if there's an area you're really struggling to get to because I've included like the names and locations that you're starting from and going to and whatnot, you can always give it a quick Google search if you're really struggling to find somewhere. Although, to be honest, the majority of the routes for all of these are included in this video, so you should be fine. But here's where we're coming to. We're going to speak to this guy. And eventually, I don't think he says anything, but just talk to him a couple of times, and he'll give you Comet Azure. There we go. Alright, now that you've got that, go back to Limgrave, and we'll go into the Waypoint Ruins, which is right there. You might not have the Site of Grace that's here, but again, as it's Limgrave, I'm guessing you've probably got Sites of Grace around it. But when you come down here, down the stairs to get into this area, you'll have to fight Mad Pumpkinhead. Again, as this is one of the earlier areas, you've probably already fought this guy, but just in case, I'll include it. Kill him, and then the back of this area will open up. Don't go up the stairs you originally came from. You've got a Site of Grace here if you want to get it too. And when you open this door, there's an NPC in there, and you'll want to choose a few specific dialogue options with her. So let's go in and talk to her. This is just to get an item that leads us to another legendary incantation and sorcery. It's the Stars of Ruin. So open up the dialogue with her so that she'll talk to you, tell her you still want to learn. Kind of just skipping through her dialogue here. And then show her the Azure sorcery. And then say, tell me your story. And then let us journey together. I have a favor to ask. And then eventually she'll give you, I think it's a key. No, the seal breaker. Celian seal breaker. And then after you've done that, we're going to need to go to Caelid, starting from Forth Farrath, which is another area you may have already been to, but there it is on the map if you haven't been there. This is all to get the same sorcery or incantation, I'm not sure which one it is. And come along here in a western direction, and then you can drop down a couple of ledges here. And then stick to the wall on your left. And you'll know you're in the right place because you'll see this big tombstone and this guy defending it. Kill him or avoid him, it's up to you. I got rid of him quickly. Just so he wasn't bothering me as I entered this next area. You can see how much weaker the stomp's got. It's actually kind of annoying because the speedrun's pretty dependent on the Hoarfrost stomp. I know people are probably down patching now to do it, but it's just annoying that you have to do that. Alright. So once you've killed him, smack this rock. That'll get you into this area. And we've got to run through this place to get this next sorcery again. I'll show you through. I haven't got a lantern, so it might be a little bit dark. Although the area where we need to get to is pretty well lit, so you should be fine. Keep going. Pretty much straightforward. Some of these walls, or when you reach these areas, you'll have to smack a wall. I'd already smacked them, so they're not there, but if you feel like you're reaching a dead end and you are following along with me, just try smacking the back wall. It'll reveal it, and you'll be able to go through. Sometimes the hidden path ahead messages aren't actually trying to troll you, you know? Alright. So, keep going. Drop down here. I think this guy managed to kill me earlier. These enemies are relatively strong, so just be careful. But, yeah, I decided this guy was going down. He was annoying. They die easily, but they just seem to do a lot of damage if they do hit you. So be careful. Alright. So heading down here. Around the side of this cliff. A couple more guys in here you'll want to watch out for. Let's get rid of them. Right, he's done. We have a glowstone there if you're interested in that. I'm pretty sure this was my first time through this part of the area, so I was a little bit confused. But you want to go down this area with the snail on right here that I'm on, and then drop down to the bottom. And the seal we need to break is in the back of this area. Yeah, just over here. You'll see the blue seal. And that key that we got, or the seal breaker, whatever it was, off that sorcerer woman. We'll open this up, and there's an NPC in here you'll have to talk to get this incantation or sorcery. Yeah, keep talking. There we go. Stars of Ruin. And that's incantation and sorcery number 3. Kind of a long one. Alright, so for this next one, we're going back to Fort Farrath. This is Grail's Roar. For this one, you have to kill the big dragon that's in this area. I know that some people are using this for a rune farm, but if you want to get this incantation or sorcery, you're going to have to kill this guy. So, I don't know if you want to back up a save or something where this guy's alive. but you're going to have to stand here and slash him for a few minutes. I tried to summon my mimic Tio here to help me out. And for some reason, he was just standing around smacking the air next to the dragon. And I had to do it all by myself. But either way, he's going to die. He'll give you a dragon heart. And then we need to go to the Cathedral of Dragon Communion to get this next one. Show where that is on the map quickly. It's just here at the bottom of Caelid. You're going to need 3 dragon hearts to get this one. You get dragon hearts by killing dragons. There's one just outside of the Dragon Communion, whatever it's called. There's also one you get from killing the big dragon. There are numerous other dragons around the map. I killed the one to get the Glintstone Key, or the one that got the Glintstone Key for my third heart, if that's something you need. Okay, so we're going back to Fort Farrath again. A lot of these are starting from there, I know. Again, trying to stick to some sort of route to make it convenient for you guys. So, come inside Fort Farrath this time and run to this area in the back where you can find a ladder. And hop all the way up. And then jump down here. And in the back of this area, there's a couple of holes. You want to jump in the one that's at the back to here. And then you're going to have to jump across here to get past this gap and drop down this hole past the rats to find Radagon's Sword Seal, which is talisman number 3.
Right. So, starting from the Star Scourge Radahn, Sight of Grace. This one's for the Redmane Knight Olga, which is the 3rd Ashen Remains. Still in Caelid. You've got to head north.
And at the back of this area, there's like a little tomb area. Huh?
When dogs get loud for videos.
Okay. So it's quite a trek to the back of this area. Just keep on going, you'll find it. It's like a closed double door type thing.
So there's a bunch of enemies in here, but you don't have to fight them. You've just got to run past them, pretty much. There's a Sight of Grace here if you want it as well. So you can only reach this area once you've beaten Radahn. And there's a bunch of areas that start opening up after you beat that boss. So Nokron and Noxtella will be covered shortly in the video. Watch out for these guys with the bows. They do a lot of damage and they're kind of annoying to avoid. But just keep coming this way. Depending on your level, these guys might be stupid strong, so just be careful. We need to jump out of one of these windows in a minute. So hop out of this window and up these stairs through this archway is another ashes. This isn't the one we want to get, but it's also another good one. So if you want to grab that, it's right there. So hop through this window and the switch we need to pull is just on the left. Hop down here.
And down here is the boss we need to beat. I think it's the putrid tree spirit. And that'll get you these ashen remains. And that's number 3 out of 6. 14 of these items collected now. Getting somewhere. Some of the more complicated ones are coming up soon though. Alright, so still in Caelid, this time at the Impassable Great Bridge. We need to go back to the area where you start the fight with Radahn. Obviously, you're only going to be able to do this after you've beaten him. So, head to the teleporter and go back in. And once you get in here, there won't be any enemies initially, but you need to head straight to the back of this area and speak to the old guy that's sitting there. Right. Okay. Come speak to this guy. And then once you've exhausted the dialogue with him, you're going to need to fast travel out of this area. Make sure you've done all the dialogue with this guy. I think I tried it a few too many times, but that's fine. Alright. So fast travel back outside to where the teleporter is. And then head back in. And now when you get back here, you'll be able to fight the boss. I think you have to fight two. It's like a duo boss. And one of them is a Crucible Knight, which isn't a lot of fun, but as you can see, I'm an expert at dodging fire. But you don't have to fight these guys. Just run past them and get to the mist. But they'd hurt my pride, so I decided to kill them. Alright, so beat this boss duo and you'll get the Ruin's Greatsword, which is armament number 5. Alright. Sorry if you can hear my dog moving about. She decides now is a good time to be loud. My girlfriend's also playing. What are you playing?
Little Nightmares.
It's a good choice. It's a good choice. It's not Elden Ring though, is it, pussy? Alright. So now we're in Laendell. Go into the Erdtree Sanctuary. We need to pull this switch. And, yeah, you might not need to actually pull that switch because the elevator might be there for you, but need to make sure you come here before you reach the point where the city turns to ash, which is after you beat the Black Blade boss, I think, in Crumbling Faramazora. So, again, I've tried to keep these in order. I probably mentioned it in the intro, but this is one of the few that you want to make sure you get before you beat the boss in Crumbling Faram. We need to jump over this railing and climb up this bolt to get this one. Bolt of Grand Sax. Right. So, now we're heading to Nokron, starting from the Ancestral Woods. If you're having trouble reaching this area, but you don't know where it is, I suggest looking it up. You only really get down here after you've beaten Radahn and followed that questline. It's essentially Ranni the Witch's questline, so if you're struggling to get here or you don't know where this area is, go and look up Ranni's questline. It's quite a long one, but eventually you'll reach this area, but you can only get here after you've beaten Radahn. That's why I've included it now, but yeah, you might want to go and have a look at that. This is for the Mimic Tier Ashes, fourth one.
Are you Googling? Have you turned it down?
Yeah, I turned it down.
Sorry, you can have your volume on. I don't mind. That's very sweet, but yeah, you can have your volume on. You're going to need a stone sword key to get in this area, and the Mimic Tier is just in this chest. I'm sure anyone who's watching the video doesn't mind listening to Little Nightmares. It's fine. Legitimately, it is a solid game.
Yeah.
It's really good, but it's not Elden Ring.
It's not. No.
Alright. So, now we're in Noxtella. This is another area that you get to by following Ranni the Witch, or that quest line. This is the site of grace you'll get pretty much straight away as you enter the city, but as you come up these stairs and up this area, there will be a lot of enemies here. I've cleaned them all out so we can just run to the talisman, but they're not particularly hard to avoid enemies. But yeah, if you want to fight them, fight them. If you want to run past, try to run past. There probably will be a few you've got to kill along the way, but because this is quite a little trek, it would take a lot longer if I killed every enemy along the way, so I've just cleared them out. This is for talisman number 4. Let's go ahead and get up here. Bunch of enemies in this room that drop down from the ceiling, so be careful of them when you first come here. They can kind of trick you. Alright, so I think the Moon of Noxtella is up here in this room, and it's going to be guarded by a few enemies. It's not too much of a tough fight compared to what you've just fought on the way up here, so you should be fine. But it's underneath this giant throne. Right. Okay, on to number 19 then. Alright, so starting from the Grand Cloister, this is at the Lake of Rot. You reach this area again after following Ranni's questline. This is kind of a shit area because of all the Scarlet Rot you have to cross to get down here, but again, if you're struggling to reach any of these areas or you don't know where they are, it's just best you look up Ranni's questline because they'll eventually bring you down here. But yeah, I'm guessing at this point you've probably found these areas, but you're going to need to spawn up there and come down to this area. And over on the left, you can see these coffins and you need to rest in the one coffin to drop you off this waterfall. Little cutscene. Skip that if you feel like it. And then once you're down here, you're gonna have a big wall of mist in the way and have to fight a boss in this area. It's quite a tough boss, but this is pretty much the end of Ranni's questline. And this will get you the Dark Moon Greatsword. I thought I'd show the last couple of steps, assuming you followed along to get this far with Ranni's questline. But you're going to have to beat this boss, which is Astel, the Natural Born of the Void. Definitely a difficult one, even if you are a higher level. If you want an easy cheese for that guy, just go and get poison arrows and sit back and just use poison arrows on him. It takes a while to kill him, but it does actually work. But when you beat him, you'll get this Sight of Grace down here. And then you're going to have to come back to the Grand Library so you can speak. Open the chest that's in here. If you haven't beaten this boss yet, you're probably going to have to come back and beat it. But she's quite a simple boss, to be honest. She's not tough. But then you'll be able to open this chest that's right here with the key that Rani has given you earlier. If you haven't got the key yet, you're going to need to go to a site of grace and talk to the Rani doll that you've picked up. Again, if you're not following with any of this, just go and look up Rani's quest line. Including it all here would definitely stretch out this video by like another hour. I'm guessing most of you know how to get that ending and follow those steps. But if you don't, go and have a little read. It's definitely a long quest line. But it will eventually bring you down this path that we're on right now. So, but completing this quest line gets you the Dark Moon Greatsword. So I've included what I could. But if you've reached the point where you can open that chest in the Grand Library, you should be fine. Alright. So, all the way up this elevator. And this will get you access to, I think it's the, is it called? The Moonlight Altar. That's the one. And this area has a good few items that we need to collect, and you'll only get up here for following Rani's quest line, like I mentioned. If you have that key that you get out of that chest, is the only way to get up here. And you may have seen this if you're running around Lyurnia or the lakes. You can see this building up on the hill. It's kind of in the corner, and I know I was scratching my head as to how to get up here at first, and there's just cliffs all over the place and you can't really see how to get up here, but this is the only way up here. So run past the dragon, don't worry about him. And there's a site of grace there if you want to get it in this area, but we're just going to come down here and down this hole. And this is where you can find Rani's body. And you just want to put the ring that you got from that chest on the Rani's body. And that will reward you with a Dark Moon Greatsword. So come down. Come and go through the dialogue with Rani. She's right here on this finger statue, but I'd already done it, so she's not there for me. But go ahead and put the ring on the statue or the body, and then you'll get the Dark Moon Greatsword. And that's it. I'm not sure if you have to continue following Rani's quest line at this point. I think it'll probably just happen if you complete the game, but if you get in the legendary items, that's pretty much all you need to do with the quest line. But now that we've got access to this area, we're going to go ahead and get Rani's Dark Moon. And to do this, we need to go to the three spots I just highlighted on the map. If you come to the Altar South site of Grace, you'll notice there's like a little statue that tells you to find three great wise beasts. And you've got to find three giant turtles. And one of them is around here somewhere on the side of this cliff, just hanging onto the cliff. I think he's right here. So you're going to have to hit him with an arrow or some kind of projectile. I'm guessing a throwing knife will do as well. You might even be able to use the Hoarfrost Stomp and just stomp it off the cliff and it'll hit it. Alright, so that's one. And now we've got to find two more. So the next one we're going to do is over here by the Evergal, right here somewhere. I think you've got to jump up into a Spirit Spring to get this one. Sort of floating above some trees. But just head towards the Evergal and you'll be in the right sort of area. There's also an enemy there that you get an Ashen Remains from that we'll be doing shortly. I think that's one of the, or in some people's opinion, the most powerful Ashen Remains in the game. It is a very good one. But let's go all the way up here. This fight was tough. This fight is probably one of the tougher fights in the game, if you ask me. It's like the assassin ringleader or something like that. Alright, let's keep coming up here. Sort of marked off where we're going to. I think the Spirit Spring is over on the right here somewhere, and I just sort of went to the Evergal and made my way from there. Yeah, it's kind of behind me. I thought originally it was on this cliff edge, but it's not. It's just over there. You can see the Spirit Spring, and that's where we need to go. So there's the Evergal, heading from that over here. And you'll need to jump into the spirit spring and hit the turtle. This might take you a few times. Well, hopefully eventually you'll hit it, like I did. Because it does, I think it kind of like circles around, so it's easy to miss. There we go. Alright. So, for number three, we're going to need to go over to the bottom right. Let's get rid of these markers. Heading towards the number two on the map. Yeah, you can't access it from that corner. I'm going to have to go all the way back around. Kind of a long-winded one, but we get there in the end. I did highlight the 3 points that you've got to go to get these turtles. Probably one of the longer ones in this guide, to be honest. So sort of like southeast corner of the area we're in. Right. Careful jumping off this cliff. Right, all the way down here. And our turtle should be just off the edge of this cliff. Again, you're going to need to shoot him. God knows how that hit the cliff, but whatever. Sorted, so let's go back to the rise. You can fast travel there if you want. Don't do any fast traveling whilst you're running around finding these turtles, or they might not spawn. I've heard some people have trouble with their spawns as well. Somebody told me that if you're having trouble with them spawning, wait till nighttime and they seem to spawn more consistently, but I'm guessing it's been patched by now, so they spawn more consistently. So let's go into the rise. The altar south. This one's definitely taking some time. I'm showing the map 15 times here for some reason, but yep, let's go. Shalona's rise. So, all the way up. And there's a chest up here somewhere. After going up this lift, probably some more stairs at the top as well. Let's go. Yeah, there's the chest. It's got Rani's Dark Moon in it. Which is incantation and sorcery number 5, number 20 on this list. Alright, so back at the Moonlight Altar. We're starting at the Ringleader's Evergale. If you followed along, we've just been there, so you're going to want to go back over there. Could have worked this in as we were over there, but I think that might have messed with the turtle spawn, so I kind of just waited till now. Yeah, this is the Black Knife Tichet Ashes. Teach, I'm not sure how you pronounce that, but Alecto, the Black Knife Ringleader. This guy sucks to fight. But get them killed to get the Black Knife Tichet, however you pronounce it. Apparently that's a very good ash. Alright, so I'm back at the Ancestral Woods now. If you've gone to Nokron, you'll have this one unlocked. But we're going to go and get Elden Stars. And this is to get to the Deep Root Depths. So if you've already got the Water Basin Site of Grace, just fast travel to there, but I've included this route for anybody who doesn't know how to get there. This is along the way where you fight the gargoyle twins, or the gargoyle duo boss fight. That's definitely a tough one. But come over here towards these jellyfish that's sort of like northeast of the Site of Grace we started at, and jump off the cliff and downhill, and run past all of these jellyfish, and you'll have to jump off the cliff here somewhere. I think it's here to get into this area here, and the game will kick you off your horse. You're in the Siophora Aqueduct now. This area took me a while to find. Definitely not an easy one to get to. So all the way through, head over to the back. And come through here. And when you get into this area, you're going to have to fight the gargoyles. Once you've got them killed, you'll get the Site of Grace that's in the back of this area, which is the water basin. So like I said, if you were going through here, so if you've already got this place spawn here, but essentially we're going to deep root depths. And this is how you get to there. I wanted to include this because I know this place took me a little while to find, and if you've beat the game, it's easy enough to miss this place. But I'm going to go ahead and hop in this coffin that's at the bottom of the waterfall. That'll take us up. Probably should have skipped this cutscene, but never mind. Alright. Long ass cutscene, I should have skipped that. Alright, so go and get the Site of Grace if you want it. And straight ahead of us over here, there's some routes that we need to follow in order to get into a cave. So let's go ahead over here. There we go. And hop over this. I'm going to come into the cave and stick to our left. Don't really have to fight these guys if you don't want to. The sorcery is just kind of sitting on a platform down here on the left. So I'll jump down here with all these, I guess, queen ants or something. There's a somber smith in stone six there if you want it. And this pickup is right here. Elden Stars. Alright, so now we're on to the mountaintops of the giants, the Freezing Lake. You're going to get here after you've got through Laendale and beaten, I think it's Godfrey. You have to go to a Site of Grace and talk to Melina, and then you'll get access to this area. And I'm going to go get the Founding Rain of Stars. So to get up here, jump up these rocks, and you'll see this bridge that looks like it's cut out, but it's actually an invisible bridge. And if you head to the end, it's a dead end, so don't drop off the edge. I was a little bit confused as to where to go here, but you've got to turn around. If you've reached the wall here like I have, you need to turn around, go back, and look out for sort of, you can sort of see clouds of mist if you angle the camera correctly. You might see here when I move my camera there on the left. You can also see where this guy's walking. And that's where you want to follow. Follow those little mist clouds to follow the stairs up and get to the heretical rise. A couple of enemies in here that are kind of annoying to fight. Let's quickly get rid of them. There we go. And then head up the stairs. I'm pretty sure there's like a chest up here for us to open. How are you supposed to find some of this stuff without a guide? I honestly don't know. Watch out for these guys, they can be seriously annoying. Some of the more annoying enemies in the game. Alright, so in this room is the chest, and that'll get you the Founding Reign of Stars. And that's all of the incantations and sorceries done. 7 of those. But now we're on to armament number 8. Here you're going to want to go to the Church of the Eclipse, again in the Mountaintops of the Giants. And this one is just in the church before you reach the boss fight with, I think it's Niall. The Eclipse Shotal, quite an easy one to find, hard to miss if you've already been to this area. So our next one is in the Consecrated Snowfield at the Cave of the Forlorn. You're going to need to run across this ravine to get down here. This is for the Golden Order Greatsword, which is the final armament on this list. If you haven't been to the Consecrated Snowfield yet, you're going to need to go and get the Secret Medallion and take it to the Grand Lift of Rold. If you're struggling to get here, it's the same lift you use to get to the Mountaintops of the Giants, but you don't need to come here to beat the game, so it's an easy one to miss. But go and look up the Secret Medallion for the Grand Lift of Rold, and it'll take you, or it'll tell you where to go and get the pieces. I think one of them is at the end of the castle we were just in to get the Eclipse Shotal. You have to beat the boss Niall, and you'll get the other half, or one of the halves of the Secret Medallion. And to get the other half, you have to go to the village of the, I think it's the Albanorks or something like that, in Lyarnia. And there's like a pot in a corner that you have to hit, and it turns into a guy, and it gives you the other half of the medallion. Again, if you're struggling to find that, or you don't know what I'm talking about, just go and look up the Secret Medallion for the Grand Lift of Rold, and you'll figure out how to get there. But or just, you know, a guide on how to get to the Consecrated Snowfield, because you do need to go and get that medallion to get here. But showing you the route on how to get through this area, because it's pretty well hidden. But at the end of this, you're going to have a boss to fight. So come down here, all the way down. This one isn't too much of a tough boss fight, considering where this is. The Consecrated Snowfield definitely has some tough enemies. One of the tougher areas in the game. But get him killed, and you'll get the Golden Order Greatsword. And that's all of the armaments. So now we're at the Hallig Tree. We're getting Marika's Sword Seal, which is the 5th talisman. Starting from the prayer room, you just want to come down here and down these stairs. Again, if you don't know how to get here, you'll have to, first, you have to go through Michaela's Hallig Tree to get to El. This is Elfale in the Hallig Tree. But to get access to that, you have to have access to the Consecrated Snowfield. And then you have to go to the area that's in the back of the Consecrated Snowfield and solve the puzzle there. Again, if you don't know how to get to any of these areas yet, it's easy enough just to look it up rather than me extending this video by a couple of hours explaining how to get to all of these areas. It's easy enough just to look it up if you're struggling. I know these areas are a little bit more complicated to get to, but I'll do my best to give a brief description of what to search for if you're struggling to find these areas and also how to do it. But if I was to include it all, it would definitely make this video a lot longer. So, but yeah, to get here, you're going to have access to the Consecrated Snowfield, and there's a puzzle in the back of it. And sort of a, it's an Evergowl area, but you'll see it, it's kind of lit up green. And you go and solve that puzzle, and then you get access to the Michaela's Hallig Tree. You get through the Hallig Tree, and then you'll get to Elfail, which is this area. Definitely a tough area, probably the hardest area in the game. So, starting back at the prayer room for this next one, this is the Clean Rotten Knight Finlay, the final ashes on this list. I think after this one, we've only got to get a few more talismans. So, once you get here, we're going to hop down and hop over here. There's a couple of enemies in this area you'll want to deal with quickly. There we go. All right. Let's go ahead and kill this guy. He's guarding the chest we need to open. Quickly get rid of him. I mean, I know they nerfed the Hoarfrost Stomp, but you can still see that it's pretty powerful. It stunlocks enemies the majority of the time, which is really nice. Doesn't do as much damage as it used to, especially when you could pair it with Knight's Repose and just do mega damage to anything in one hit, but they nerfed that so that the Knight's Repose doesn't affect other weapons, which is kind of annoying, but that's just the way it is. All right. So now we're getting the Dragon's Crest Great Shield Talisman. We're at the Drainage Channel in Elfail, or the Hallig Tree. And coming down here, we need to run across these roots. And once you get across here, we're going to need to drop down onto this other ledge. And then across this root. We need to get up to that hole in the roof over there, so we're just going to come down here, drop onto this ledge, come up, hop onto this route, and down into the hole, onto these sort of rafters. Then we need to hop across these ledges and onto this platform. Watch out for the pests that are down here. Kill them. I think this guy, I killed the little ones, and then I think the other guy kind of just fell off the edge or something, but he was still managing to, like, NASA launch pest missiles up at me somehow. But yeah, the chest has the talisman in it, which is number 6. 2 more to get then. Alright. So, number 7, I think, is in the Crumbling Faramazura area. This is the Old Lord's Talisman. We're beside the Great Bridge. If you've beaten the Black Blade, or you know where that boss fight is, you should know this Site of Grace quite well. We're going to come around here and head the opposite direction of the boss and back over this way. I think this was the last talisman that I needed, but there is one more, keeping it in order in this video, but this is the last one I needed to get. So, down here, kill these enemies if you want to. I'd advise killing the enemies as you approach them, because in a minute you're going to enter a room with a bunch of enemies in it that can kill you really quickly, so you might want to kill these guys. I was kind of getting stun locked on this ladder for a second. So, following the path, most of these enemies are already dead, but I'd say be ready, because you're going to get invaded when you get near this chest. So, Once you get down here, this is the talisman location, but there's all these enemies in here. They managed to get me killed once, but look out for the invasion you get in this area as well. Be ready for that. But there's the Old Lord's Talisman. And that's 7 out of 8. Number 29 on this list. One more to get. For this one, you're going to have to have had the capital turned to ash by beating the Black Blade in Crumbling Pharum's Azura. This is the Erdtree's favour. You need to start at the Forgotten Lands, which is the path to the mountaintops of the giants. You'll come through here and use the elevator, the Grand Lift of Rold, to get to the mountaintops of the giants. But the only way to get back to this area is to go back through the lift. It doesn't actually take you too far. There's not too much to explore, but coming back here gets you the talisman. Is the only way to get to it. So we're going to have to go back through this way. It's quite a trek. I was messing with my armor here just to put some other armor on or something. Kind of looking at some of the stuff I picked up. This armor you can get really early on in the game, but it's one of the coolest looking ones if you ask me. Alright. So we need to go all the way across this bridge and watch out for the knights that are on it over towards the other side. If you haven't turned the city to ash yet by beating the Black Blade, then you won't be able to get this talisman just yet, but there's a reason I've left this one till very last, and that's just because you can easily get locked out of other ones if you do this one earlier, you know. If you rush to get to this point in the game and you don't get the one in Lanedale, you can easily miss it. So that's why I've left this one till very last. You can always get it maybe just before you start journey number 2 and then work from there, you know. This is the only one that's in the City of Ash, but you just want to make sure you've cleaned out the other stuff before you get this done. Alright. Just waiting for this lift. Alright. Down we go.
So once you get down here to where you need to be, there's going to be,
I think, 3 tree spirits that are hanging around. I'm not sure if you kill them if you get golden seeds. I made a little golden seed video a while ago, and since then I've found a couple more, but you only need a certain amount to get the maximum upgrades, and there's no achievement tied to getting them all. I kind of wish there was, but never mind. Alright, so watch out for the tree spirits. There are 3 of them hanging around here, which is kind of annoying. And just come over here to the back corner and get the Erdtree's favour number 2, which is the final legendary item on this list. That's all of them, all 30. So I hope the guides helped you out. If you want to support the video, you know what to do. I'll put some more Elden Ring content on screen for you. If you want to support me further, you can always check out my live stream at twitch.tv/iFreams. Thanks for watching. And yeah, that's about it from me. I'll see you next time.